Hi all, welcome to Smart Leaders IAS. We have been doing our daily newspaper analysis under the name of Smart Catalyst for the 2 months. Apart from doing the daily newspaper analysis, now we are starting a thematic deep dive of topics relevant to MAINS. Every video we will be having a deep discussion of a particular topic. Today we will be discussing the outcomes of COP24 of UNFCCC that happened in Katowice, Poland. Before going into the topic, we have to know what climate change is. Climate change is a change in the statistical weather pattern of a region over a period of time. And this period of time extends from decades to millions of years. The climate change is caused by global warming. Global warming has been happening naturally, but due to the anthropogenic pressures, the impact of global warming on change in climatic pattern has been increasing and it is visible. How climate change happens naturally? If we go through the geological history of the Earth, we get to see that Earth was once filled with ice. The period was known as Ice Age. During the Ice Age, the bursts of carbon dioxide found an ally with the incoming sunlight. These both led to warming of the planet. And this process led to the origin of life in the Earth. So climate change happening naturally, it had the potential of creating new life, but the anthropological pressure created by the human activity in the name of economic development has caused much problem to the equilibrium of the earth. This has triggered the negative consequences of climate change. In order to counter the increasing global temperature over a period of time, various organizations like IPCC, WMO, they all have been organizing scientific studies, and based on that, many measures have been undertaken. And all these concerted efforts to control the negative aspects of climate change has been organized under an umbrella body of UNFCCC. And this UNFCCC has been organizing the Conference of Parties every year. And this Conference of Parties are most important because the initiatives and the measures to be taken by the global countries are decided in this Conference of Parties as a democratic manner to control the menace of climate change. Of them, a few important COPs were the Kyoto, Marrakesh. Kyoto and Marrakesh marked the phase one of countering climate change. The phase 2 of countering climate change started with the Paris Climate Accord of 2015. And the rule book for Paris Climate Accord was signed in the recently concluded COP24 Katowice Summit. In order to understand the outcomes of Katowice Summit, it is imperative for us to understand the outcomes of Paris Climate Agreement. Let's see the Paris Climate Agreement now. Paris Climate Agreement is an holistic agreement in the area of climate change. It covers important areas like controlling temperatures, arrangement of finances, specialized action for specialized problems, fixing emission goals for different countries, burden sharing among developing and developed countries, and apart from this, doing all this properly needs a review mechanism. It also speaks about the review mechanism. And first time forever, the climate change initiative spoke about loss and damage only in Paris. So these are the broad areas covered by Paris Climate Agreement. Of them, the most important to note is that in the Paris COP21, the countries agreed to restrict the rise in temperature to 1.5 degrees Celsius by 2030 at the levels of 2005. Since the goal of 1.5 degrees Celsius was too ambitious, the countries agreed to have another target of restricting the temperature difference by 2 degrees Celsius. Only two countries, say Gambia and Morocco, agreed to restrict the temperature difference at 1.5 degrees Celsius. And the recently released global climate report of IPCC indicates that even if the countries, all the signatories of Paris Climate Agreement, they restrict the temperature difference at 1.5 degrees Celsius, even then the effect of climate change in the Earth will be more dangerous. We spoke about the recent IPCC report earlier. So in order to understand the mechanism that links the emissions with the global warming has to be understood in order to move forward. Consider this graph present in the screen. Here, the y-axis mentions the temperature and emission. The temperature is given in red, and the emission level is marked in black. And the x-axis indicates the time. Earlier, initially, the emissions were low and the temperature overshoot was low. Then came the Industrial Revolution. Increasing numbers of polluting industries all over the world, the emissions increased. With the emissions, the temperature also got overshooted. And it has reached a tipping point now. Now we are in 2018. And this is a most dangerous point. If at all we don't reduce our emissions, we will have a temperature overshoot over and above the target fixed by the international organization. This is the target, say 2 degrees Celsius restriction. We need rapid decarbonization in our economies and new innovative technologies to induce negative emission in order to reduce the emissions, which will in turn reduce the temperature. In order to achieve the goals set in Paris Climate Agreement, the country should invest more in rapid decarbonization and new technologies that would induce negative emissions. So how would rapid decarbonization happen? Rapid decarbonization can be majorly done by increasing the forest cover. New technologies to sequester carbon dioxide from atmosphere. The negative emissions is related with the technologies of climate engineering. So these were the points given by the IPCC in its Global Climate Report 2018. And this IPCC report was an important point of discussion in the Katowice Summit. Initially, we saw about Paris Climate Accord. Then we saw about the IPCC report, which spoke about restricting the temperature difference at the desired level to have a sustainable future for our younger generation. Initially, we saw about the Paris Climate Accord, then we saw about the IPCC report on climate change. Now, let's have a brief look into the deliberations that happened and the outcomes of the Katowice Summit. As we discussed earlier, the rule book for Paris Climate Accord was finalized in Katowice Summit. The Paris Climate Agreement discusses about achieving ambitious goals, but no achievements can be done without a set of rules and frameworks. And these rules and framework was offered by Katowice Summit. The functional set of the rules for Paris Climate Accord provisions were finalized. Also, the member countries of UNFCCC provided reassurance and support towards capacity building for the developing countries. The climate change, for that matter, any natural hazards, natural disaster, affects the vulnerable more. In the global scenario, the vulnerable are the small economies, developing economies and underdeveloped economies. As we discussed earlier in the IPCC graph, that we need innovative technologies. Technology needs money. The small economies, developing economies and underdeveloped economies, they are deprived of financial strength to build technologies to avert the catastrophe of climate change. So the member countries, they gave reassurance for capacity building in the Katowice Summit. There are a few important articles of the Paris Climate Accord. We have to know that. Under Kyoto Protocol, we all remember that there were some important market-based intervention tools like CDM, Clean Development Mechanism, CDM, Carbon Trading, similar market intervention mechanism also continues with the Paris Climate Accord. These are mentioned in Article 6 of the Paris Climate Agreement. And the Article 9 speaks about the most important area, climate financing. We have had important climate agreements earlier, like the Kyoto Protocol of 1997. Kyoto Protocol was legally enforceable, and the participating countries were given a targets which they should achieve. Whereas in the case of Paris Climate Accord, the countries were given with voluntary targets which they must strive to achieve, but there is no compulsion on them to achieve their targets. Those are known as intended nationally determined contributions. These NDCs are given under the Article 4 of Paris Climate Accord. The Katowice Summit has successfully framed the rule book for Paris Climate Accord, encompassing all provisions of the Paris Agreement. So this was the first outcome of the Katowice Summit. The next most important outcome of the Katowice Summit was Silesia Declaration. Silesia is a geographical region surrounding a part of Poland, Czech Republic. This region is known for its abundant coal mining. So what was this Silesia Declaration all about? With the increasing impact of climate change and the polluting potential of fossil fuels, most of the countries are now moving away from coal. But the coal mining has been an important employer for millions of workers. Then their future becomes a big question mark. So this Silesia Declaration speaks about just and fair transition. The main aim of this Silesia Declaration is to provide alternative employment opportunities for the laborers hitherto employed in coal mines, and they should be given a fair and just transition. This is the main aim of the Silesia Declaration. Under the Silesia Declaration, it was agreed up by the member countries that workers and unions will have a seat at negotiating table that takes decision on climate mitigation talks. Also, it was decided that in order to move fast towards the targets fixed by the UNFCCC in mitigating climate change, the role of workers should be identified and the just and fair transition to a new job should be ensured. So, Silesia Declaration was an important milestone which was signed in Katowice Summit. The next important declaration that was signed in Katowice Summit was the Forest for Climate Change Declaration. Of climate change, one important factor is to induce decarbonization. In order to have effective decarbonization, increasing forest cover plays a crucial role. Forests act as an important tool towards achieving the decarbonization targets. Forests act as a natural sink for carbon. Almost all the plants are built upon the carbohydrates of which the building blocks is carbon. So growing more trees would absorb more carbon dioxide from the atmosphere. And apart from absorbing the excess carbon dioxide and acting as a sink, natural sink for carbon dioxide, they also provide cooling effect to the planet. By all these three aspects, increasing forest cover helps in averting the climate change disaster. In the summit, the recent survey undertaken by World Resources Institute was discussed upon, and it was heartening to note that the average 3-year moving average of forest cover all over the world has increased between the years of 2016 and 17. This is heartening. Also, increasing the forest cover helps in achieving climate neutrality. Article 5 of Paris Climate Accord speaks about bringing in climate neutrality by increasing the forest cover. Considering the multifarious beneficial roles played by the forest in averting the catastrophe of climate change, the countries should understand that there is no future without combating climate change, and combating climate change has no future without conserving forests. And this Forest for Climate Change was one of the another important declaration that was signed in the Katowice Summit. Last important declaration to be signed in the Katowice Summit was about e-mobility. In the e-mobility declaration, the countries, the member countries, they discussed about improving technology that helps in improving the lives of human, thereby conserving the nature. And e-mobility that uses electricity is important way to reduce the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. The e-vehicles releases less pollutants comparing to the conventional fossil fuel run vehicles. So the pollutants are less, the global warming is less, hence the impact of climate change can be reduced. Apart from using e-mobility, there are also other alternative fuels can also be used. Alternative fuels like methane, methanol and ethanol can be used. And this alternative fuel technologies, they can also make use of decarbonization technologies like sequestration. Recent working paper published by Columbia University . It was demonstrated that carbon dioxide, when electrolyzed, gets converted into ethyl alcohol, which is a clean fuel. So innovative technologies like this can be used in order to produce pollution-free electricity, and this pollution-free electricity can be used to run non-polluting vehicles, which is far better than the polluting fossil fuels in the world, which in turn would reduce the impact of climate change catastrophe. As in the case of Bonn Summit 2017, the Katowice Summit was also based on Talanova dialogue mechanism, which was a consensus based discussion mechanism. But major criticism in the process was that the decision were taken in urgency without considering without weighing in the problems being faced by the developing countries and small island countries. Proper representation should be given to the vulnerable in order to restrict the climate change hazard from becoming a climate change disaster. Thank you.